Our next speaker is Dr. Priyanka Sharma. She has a PhD. She's CEO of Cosmira LLC, which is a manufacturing company which focuses on large-scale production of botanical extracts from industrial hemp. All right, I'd love to for your presentation.
Thanks, Shelley, for the introduction. Thanks, everyone, for joining today. I'm going to talk today about setting standards for purity in the industry, as well as importance of licensing in manufacturing companies, of course, safety and other validation procedures that are important in manufacturing and industrial hemp derived products. So I'll talk a little bit about Cosmira. So just to get everyone's in perspective, we are not a retail company. We are a large scale manufacturer of CBD oil and CBD isolate. Just to give you an idea of scale, we process about 5,000 to 6,000 pounds of hemp per day. And by the end of that, each month, we generate more than a couple hundred kilos of product from that. We have a facility in Watkins, Colorado, approximately 200,000 square foot space. We have processing there as well as storage and different other components. We have a proprietary purification technology which allows us to produce THC-free CBD products. And this is something that's been really important in the industry, kind of identifying. I know Bob talked a lot about 0.3% THC. In the industry, actually, THC-free is considered non-detect THC in products. And our technology is able to get that to a non-detect level. Of course, the 0.3%, we believe is not that much THC anyways, but there's many products out there that use THC-free oil as the raw material, such as tinctures and gummies and other things. So our product is seen in many stores and many companies across the U.S. In different, end products such as vape, pens, as I mentioned, gummies. We are the raw material provider for all of those end products. This past year, we had a contract grow in Southern Colorado where we planted 240 acres of industrial hemp, and we're continuing to extract from that as well as other sources of feedstock in Colorado. So, my husband who's sitting here, we're co-CEOs of Cosmira. His name is Pulak Sharma. We were just at a conference in New York for the past couple of days called DCAT. And this is where all large pharmaceutical companies in the U.S. gather. We had meetings with Merck and Pfizer, Genentech, other companies. We come from a oil and gas refining background as well as a pharmaceutical background. We've built large purification systems and set up refineries around the world before we started Cosmira. And something interesting was said to us by these pharma companies, because of course they're into producing APIs and generics, and they're just starting to hear of CBD and considering use of that as an API. And the one thing they said to us, which was so important to hear, is that you're going to stay afloat as a company when you're legitimate. That means having proper quality management procedures and producing your product in a safe and efficacious manner. And with that, I'm going to talk about different things, but here's our facility, and I talk about class 1, div 1. This is really an important consideration that anyone in the manufacturing space should take for their facility. With this certification of having class 1, div 1 facilities, you can really ensure your product is being produced in a safe manner. Now, I'm going to go over this slide very quickly because I think Sean will cover this in his Q&A as well. But the CBD market expected growth is huge by 2020. you know, there's no doubt that there'll be many more people making products and many more consumers of this product. And this number may be changed, you know,
looks
Sean
familiar,
can fill us in. you know, annual hemp production in the U.S., this is going to increase as well. We hear every day of our friends in Kentucky, you know, turning over their tobacco farms to produce hemp. And so we're going to have even more industrial hemp producing in the United States. Of course, there's many uses right now of CBD products, you know, all surrounding anti-inflammatory pain management purposes. And they're going to be going into different segments. There's going to be nutraceutical. There's going to be pharmaceutical. That is just how this works. It's happened before with fish oil. It's happened with krill oil, where pharma has had a fight before with the nutraceutical companies. Fish oil is one that comes to mind, where you can get prescribed Lavazza at your doctor's office, or you can go buy omega-3s at Sam's Club or Costco or what have you. So the same thing will likely happen with CBD oil, but because of the political nature of this, it might take a little bit longer to get there. But I want to talk about, you know, really today, how are we going to make these products that, you know, safely, most importantly, but, you know, also what Kazmira is doing is high efficiency and scale, because, you know, producing product from 100,000 acres of industrial hemp, that's going to require technologies that can produce at scale and efficiently and cost effectively. So I'm just going to walk through a little bit quickly about the Kazmira process. We take industrial hemp in different forms. It can be in sticks and stems, it can be shucked, sometimes it comes in powdered forms, and we have an extraction process. And this goes into chromatography, which is what we use as part of our purification process. And we produce the two products, which is the CBD isolate and the THC-free CBD oil. Now, different licensing, that's important, and that you should look for from facilities that you're purchasing your products from. One is ISO 9001, which is, this is a very common certification that all pharmaceutical companies have, all manufacturing facilities have this in the US. This is, again, a quality management system, so it means that you have your SOPs, you have your incident logs, you have your CAPAs, you're constantly looking at quality of your product throughout its whole life cycle. So for instance, anyone can come to us who had purchased product from the first day we started processing last March to yesterday and ask me which feedstock it came from, and I'll be able to tell you that. So that's how much control you have through your life cycle process in your facility. GMP, of course, as Bob mentioned, the certification is not here yet for hemp companies, but a compliance review can be done by, you know, ISC or other governing bodies that can do ISO certification. So, you know, we encourage you to look for companies that have at least gone through a GMP compliance procedure. The CDPHE license, especially important for Colorado, which allows the company to manufacture and process these plants as a food product. Class 1, Division 1 rated facility. So this basically means you have explosion-proof facilities. All of your wiring, all of your plugs for your equipment, everything you're doing is taking place in this kind of a facility, and that's really for the safety of your employees, of course, who are operating this equipment. Pending that you're using solvents in your process, you need to be having EPA permits. This is something that's super important and a lot of people miss, and this is a huge problem that we've seen in companies where they don't have proper permits for solvent usage as well as disposing of solvents. And of course, this is part of ISO, but this is something that we think is really important. A compliance program for accepting industrial hemp feedstock. If you're somebody like us who buys feedstock from different sources in Colorado, there needs to be a procedure for accepting that feedstock to make sure that it is in fact industrial hemp, because as far as I understand, you know, from Bob and talking to Sean and other, you know, Sam, there's different things that can happen when you can have product in your facility that doesn't qualify as hemp. So you should make sure of that. Now, this is an example of different facilities that Pollock and I have been a part of commissioning in the past 4 to 5 years. There's this in particular is was a plant for stevia. There's also a picture here from a plant we did for omega-3. So this is the kind of facilities that, you know, show you that they care about safety. There's proper piping. There's closed loop systems. These are things that are really important when it comes to having a safe manufacturing facility. And just quickly, I'd like to talk about different extraction technologies. You know, you may have heard of supercritical CO2 extraction, light hydrocarbon extraction as well, which is with butane most commonly. These are also technologies that are available for extracting hemp, but again, they need to be in facilities that are rated for this. And you know, we've definitely come across facilities in Colorado, and I'm sure many of you have heard of different facilities being shut down because they're not operating properly and within, you know, compliance for this type of technology. So these are the symbols that are common when you see for, you know, fire hazards or pressure hazards, and these are things that you know, are part of these different technologies. Now, in terms of purity standards, there's a couple of labs that are considered third-party labs, and they themselves have their own ISO certification. One of them is ProVerde. So getting certificates of analysis for your product is very important, so you know what is in the product. I don't believe that USP, they're another certification body, has yet come to the hemp industry giving people a stamp on their product yet, but the most important thing you can do in terms of maintaining purity and making sure you know what's in your product is being able to get that certificate from third-party labs. And we, of course, work very closely with them to make sure that what we're testing is similar to, you know, thing analysis that they're getting. This is just an example of analysis that we do in our lab. We have HPLCs, and they allow you to look at what's inside your product. Casmira oil, we've made a couple of different batches. This is one from the past week where you can see the CBD content and other cannabinoid content. Other oils that we get from customers, they just give us samples here and there. We've been able to test different cannabinoids in them to show, of course, they're not THC-free. And this is why it's super important, again, to get your purity tests done. So at this point, I'm just going to finish by saying that Casmira, again, is a large manufacturer. We've been around now for just over a year. And you know, we have different programs that involve mentorship of young engineers. We, of course, really try to recruit female engineers from the Denver area. There's a lot coming out of Colorado School of Mines, as well as CU Boulder and CU Denver. And you know, we encourage anyone who knows engineers to sort of spread the word about getting involved in this industry, because there are companies like us which will make their experience very similar to working in oil and gas and nutraceutical and other common industries that engineers go into. And with that, I'd just like to thank you for attending today, and we'll be available at the end for any questions.